Welcome back to the Politbureau. The Integrity Commission of the ANC has reportedly written to eThekwini Mayor Zandile Gumede to step down. This follows allegations of a multi-million rand waste removal tender. Gumede is accused of influencing the outcome of that bidding process. So far, around 11 people stand as co-accused in the matter. Gumede is out on 50,000 rand bail. And if you watched the Nedbank Cup final, you would have seen the mayor actually getting down. But before we get into the nitty-gritties around that, just take a listen to what this ANC supporter had to say about the arrest of Zandile Gumede.
We are in politics. Anything turns out to be a smear campaign in any form. So if you want to unseat a political leader, find the crime that he may have done. Whether it's there or not, he is left to himself to stay at home and prove it. So that one becomes mischievous if you approach it that way. So that's what we are saying. That's why we are saying when you arrest a person, it must have been a compelling evidence to say, I can prosecute. Now to arrest a person and say, come back next week, come back 6 months later, you're still investigating. So we feel that that is a systematic way of unseating that person from whatever position he's holding.
Political analyst Xolani Dube is still with us in studio. Listening to that bite, what do you take from it? And also considering the people who are outside the provincial headquarters of the party protesting, what do you make of it?
Deja vu. Mm-hmm. ANC is stagnated in deja vu. It's stagnated in the past. We have seen it before, this kind of chaos, and we are no longer surprised. But what we have to ask ourselves are very simple questions. Why certain acts are supposed to be done post-apartheid and at certain times where people think these acts are twinned with the issues of political expediency, with factionalism and so forth. And I don't think that the issue of Mamu Zandile Gumede, really, if we look at it, is something that we are supposed to be surprised. But what we have to ask ourselves as South African citizens, as I've said, there is a mayor in Newcastle that was seen moving around with the president of our country. Mm-hmm. And the ANC in KwaZulu-Natal made a statement and took a decision that all those who are alleged to be involved in criminal activities are supposed to vacate their offices. But the guy is still there, executing his duties as a mayor. And so we can't expect that Mam Zandile will vacate that particular office if the laws that have been laid down by the ANC are not applicable to the other side. Mm-hmm. You get what I mean? And so laws are supposed to serve justice, and they are supposed to be applicable equally. And another thing that is coming is the issue of Eastern Cape, as we have read newspapers that also something is brewing there when it comes to Oscar Mabuyane and the treasurer of the ANC. And so I think the ANC currently is facing a serious problem when it comes to its leadership and how it applied laws.
How then do you read a situation where Mike Mabuyakulu was on the province-to-province list and then he decided to withdraw his name from that list and then compare to Mam Zandile? Of course, Mike Mabuyakulu, of course, not holding any political position at the moment, I believe.
Remember that there was a Savio case of water purification. That case, it even collapsed while Mike Mabuyakulu was the MEC of Economic Development. You get what I mean? And so he never vacated his position. So as always, Mampeki was an MEC for health. She never vacated her position there. And so the case now that is happening, Mam Zandile is the mayor, as well as the mayor of Newcastle is still the mayor. They are not vacating their offices. You get what I mean? And so there are also other people in the ANC who have been suspected of wrongdoings. They are still occupying their offices. And so that's why I'm saying even the Integrity Committee can come and say, Mam Zandile, we are finding you on the wrong side of the law, vacate your office, but is silent when it comes to the guy from Newcastle. Why I'm using these two cases is to say, justice in the ANC, it seems as if it's not applicable equally. So as a citizen, we are sandwiched between not knowing whether these state institutions are serving the interest of a particular faction or are serving the justice of South Africans.
Just a quick one before we move on this. The Integrity Commission, for instance, had taken a decision relating to one of the mayors in Limpopo relating to the VBS scandal. She stepped down. Why can't Zandile Gumede do the same thing and just step down if the Integrity Commission says, please step down because you are implicated in this matter? Instead of saying that, while you have the mayor was in Newcastle who is still there, why should I be stepping down? There's already been precedence that has been set in Limpopo, for instance, where the mayor there stepped down. Why can't Zandile Gumede do exactly the same thing?
But look, the president of the ANC as well of the country nullified that particular president by courtshipping the mayor of Newcastle. You get me? And so that's why I'm saying that to a certain extent, the people who are advising Cyril in KwaZulu-Natal are not doing an excellent job. They are misleading him.
And let's speak about the ANC in KwaZulu-Natal. Do you think that the party has been able to unify the ANC in that province, also taking into consideration that you had Begicele, for instance, saying that, or the Minister of Police, saying that this province is one of those provinces which is a hotspot. And then you have the political killings that are taking place. And now you have this particular case as well that's taking place. And as you've heard in the bite earlier on, the person almost seems to be alluding to factional battles that are happening within the ANC and then using these corruption allegations to try and remove people who had been elected to those positions.
Look, I think even Peggy Clarence comes to KwaZulu-Natal is very compromised. Look at how he messed up with the case of Ndobe. You get what I mean? Mm-hmm. And look at how he was campaigning for Cyril prior the NASREC. And so, as I've said even earlier on, I think there's lot of things that are happening in that particular province in KwaZulu-Natal that also make Begicele to be really compromised, because his intervention in that particular province is being viewed with a jaundiced eyes to say, possibly he's not doing it for really to serve the justice, but he's doing for his own political social upward mobility.
You know, I had an interview with Khalima Motlanthe, former President Khalima Motlanthe, a couple of weeks ago, and he was speaking about what happens within the ANC and how people get appointed to certain positions. But very important to this is the role that was played by the Scorpions at the time. He said that the Scorpions were seen as this organization that goes around, it speaks about its success rate and so forth, but when in actual fact it doesn't have the success rate. And I wonder now whether what the Hawks is doing is that the Hawks is trying to save face, to say that, listen, look at us, we are actually acting, but also taking into consideration the timing of it, when it's happening. It's happening after the elections.
I think timing is very important, because timing is also coupled with lot of perception, and perception in politics is the reality. You can't let a person not be arrested at a particular time, and then you arrest that particular person when it suits you, because that also fuels perceptions.
Who sets to benefit from an unstable KZN?
Look, you have to understand that politics is about power. And if you want to rule, sometimes it's about divide and rule.
But who benefits?
Look, just like any other politician, if a particular faction is not on your side, what you do, you go there and you punish those who are not on your side, and then you reward those who
Does
are on your side.
Does it matter at all that Sihle Zikalala seem to have flipped?
Look, as I said, politics also for other people is about livelihood. Can you imagine them outside politics? How are they going to survive? And so flip-flopping for them is what brings food at home. You get what I mean? And so for Sihle to the perception that is with now with Cyril, I think time in this case is going to be the arbiter, and is the time that is going to judge all this perception if Sihle really is on the side of Cyril Ramaphosa.
I think one of those tests will come tomorrow, when former President Jacob Zuma appears in court. Do you think that Sihle Zikalala would want to be seen as someone who still supports the former president?
They've been submarining, you know, they've been quiet. But sometimes in politics, you need not to be overt. You can be covert in your operations. Mm-hmm. You get what I mean? And so knowing how Jacob Zuma has been operating, and so he can put moles to say, look, in order to protect this particular perception, act in this particular way, in a covert manner. But at the end of the day, know where your allegiance is.
But will we see the same numbers that we saw before the elections of people, ANC supporters, appearing in support of former President Jacob Zuma outside court?
We have to understand that now the ANC is there is cleavage that is happening in the ANC. There is this disintegration. If you have heard what Ace was saying yesterday, to say we're coming for everything, and also to say the ANC can't survive on the crumbs or on the crumbs of the white monopoly capital. And so there's that particular narrative that is being pumped. And we have to bear in mind also that JZ in our society, he is the representation of the outcast, of those who are seen to be ostracized by the system. And so definitely tomorrow, him as the representation of those, they will be there in numbers. And bear in mind what is interesting, it will be during the time of economic activity, but those guys will be there. It shows that the people are unemployed. They still look at JZ as the figure father that will take them to the promised land,
Well, we'll have to wait and see whether that will happen on Monday. Xolani Dube, thank you so much for your time. After the break, the prejudice suffered from racism or even unintended racism.